Aloha, Kauai. Here's our daily COVID-19 briefing from Team Kauai for Friday, August 7th. Happy Aloha Friday. Our cumulative number of cases remains at 47. While we are pleased to report that we have no new cases and no active cases here on Kauai, we are very concerned that there are 201 cases reported statewide today. This continued spike in cases across the state is the reason Governor Ige and our mayors have pushed for stronger restrictions in hopes that we can get a handle on this current outbreak and contain the spread. Yesterday, Governor Ige and Mayor Caldwell made a significant announcement with several rules. Some of those rules affect just the city and county of Honolulu, but there are also rules that affect all of us. This can get confusing and leads to a lot of questions from our citizens, and questions are good because it means people want to do the right thing. So we want to talk a little bit more about rules today. As the governor of the state of Hawaii, Governor Ige has in place an emergency proclamation that applies to all of us across the state. The governor's proclamation determines our current impact level. At the start of the pandemic, our impact level was a stay-at-home order, which required all of us to stay home unless it was absolutely necessary to go out. Since that time, we have progressed to act with care, and we remain in the act with care impact level today. The governor's emergency proclamation also focuses on the mandatory traveler quarantine, but we'll talk about quarantines more in just a minute. In addition to the governor's statewide emergency proclamation, each county mayor has the authority to create mayor's emergency rules for their respective counties. We often refer to these as local rules. On Thursday, Honolulu Mayor Caldwell announced new local rules for the city and county of Honolulu, which shut down parks, beaches, and several types of businesses. We want to clarify that these specific rules apply to Oahu only. As much as possible, here on Kauai, we'd like to avoid shutting down our beaches and businesses again. One of the ways we can help to prevent shutting down businesses and activities is by reinstating the inter-island quarantine, which Governor Ige announced yesterday. Here's the new rule on quarantines. Starting Tuesday, August 11th, every person arriving on Kauai, Hawaii Island, or Maui County must quarantine for 14 days, regardless of whether you are a resident or visitor, regardless of whether you came from the mainland or Oahu or another neighbor island. If you arrive here on Kauai after August 11th, you will be required to quarantine for 14 days. Just like before, there will be limited exceptions to the quarantine rule, such as for critical infrastructure employees as defined by the Department of Homeland Security. Also, those who need to travel off-island for medical care will be allowed an exemption. If you must travel inter-island during the mandatory quarantine period and feel you qualify for an exemption, please email covidexemption@hawaii.gov. Again, for questions on quarantine exemptions, please email covidexemption@hawaii.gov. We've also heard from parents who are concerned about students returning to college on Oahu or other islands later this month. We want you to know that we've heard your concerns and we are in discussions with state leadership, and hopefully they will have a decision soon. We will have more details for you in the coming days. While I realize it's frustrating to feel like we're going backwards, the situation on Oahu affects all of us. Implementing a quarantine adds a layer of protection to help keep our island safe and our beaches and businesses open. As a final reminder, tomorrow, August 8th, is primary election day. Please vote. Our elections office mailed out 40,393 ballots for the primary election. As of this morning, they reported receiving 19,157 back. An additional 237 people voted at the Voter Service Center in the county's Piikoi building. Those are promising numbers, but we can do better. There are still time to drop off your ballot at one of the primary election drop boxes at the Hanalei, Kapa'a, Kalaheo, and Hanapepe fire stations. You can also return ballots at the PEcoy Building Voter Service Center or the Elections Office next to the historic county building. All drop boxes are constructed of stainless steel and have been customized with purple badging and the county seal. They are accessible 24 hours a day and will be open until 7 p.m. on primary election day tomorrow, Saturday, August 8th, 2020. You can also vote in person at the Voter Service Center on Saturday, August 8th from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. If you're going to visit the Voter Service Center, please wear your mask. For additional information, contact the Office of the County Clerk, Elections Division at 241-4800. We want to end today's update by simply saying mahalo. For every person out there who is wearing your mask and practicing physical distancing, for every person who has opted out of going to a barbecue with your friends or birthday parties with your extended ohana, or may have even skipped a wedding or funeral for a loved one, for every business owner making adjustments to your operation, for all of you out there for making sacrifices, big and small, we say mahalo. You're making a difference. You are the reason we will get through this. You're the reason we are lucky to live Kauai. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you. As our numbers continue to rise across the state, please continue to be responsible when you leave your home and engage with others. We each have a role to play in mitigating the spread of COVID-19 on our island. That means stay home as much as possible. Refrain from social gatherings or public outings. If you must interact with people outside of your home, maintain a distance of 6 feet of separation and wear a mask, if at all possible for you to do so. Remember, my mask protects you and your mask protects me. It's a sign of respect and aloha. Do not leave home if you are sick unless you're seeking medical attention, and then only after calling your doctor first. Wash your hands frequently and clean surfaces often. Stay informed and connected during this time of social distancing. We'll continue to post updates on our official County of Kauai Facebook page or on our Kauai Emergency Management Agency page at www.kauai.gov/COVID-19. The Centers for Disease Control is also updating its website regularly. For more information, please visit coronavirus.gov. Not everyone has internet access or follows the news, so please help to keep your loved ones informed. Be kind, take care of one another, God bless, and aloha.